Hey, morning, guys. It's Wednesday. Very early on a Wednesday, actually. But Wednesday means it's hiccup day. And I really want to thank you guys for introducing me into the genre and kind of, helping me along the way, introducing me to the players and stuff like that. The first song we're going to do today was actually suggested by Stephen Kyle, and it's Twang and Round called Bury Me. I don't know anything about it. I haven't heard the song, don't know the players, but I'm going to, so let's just get it. I just want to go back for a minute. What the hell does this say here? Octagon. If any of you guys know what this actually says here, can you help me out and let me know? I've never seen this flag before. I don't know what all this means. I mean, it wasn't bad. There were two things that I had a little bit of issue with. One, they had a lot to say in their rap. I mean, I understand the concept of their rap, which is they have a lot to overcome, you know. They have all these strikes against them, you know, and that's why they're having a hard time overcoming. But they were cramming so much into what they were saying, in, you know, into their bars. It was almost like, and then trying to have a hook in there on top of it, that it was just almost too much. You know how they say too much of a good thing? That's almost what it was, you know what I mean? It would have been a lot easier. They could have said what they wanted to say in simpler terms. The other thing was that one guy, one of their voices, I don't know their name, so I don't know which one was Twang. I don't know which one was Round. But his voice was just so... I don't even know if high is the word, but it's just so, oh God, please don't butcher me. It's almost like nails on a chalkboard. It's very hard to get your ear around. A lot of people said that about Eminem when he first came out, because he didn't have that typical rapper, almost street voice, that gruff kind of voice that rappers had at the time. But then, you know, when Outkast came out, Andre 3000 didn't have, you know, that gruff voice. He had more of an Eminem voice. It was more of a, you know, that type of voice. But this guy is like, I don't know, Eminem on steroids. I don't know what to say. It's almost like he sucked a helium balloon before he started rapping. That's how high pitched his voice was. That, it was almost hard for me to concentrate on his rhyme because I was trying to overcome his voice to listen to it. God, I'm sorry. I have been having serious trouble with my eyes for the last couple days. But anyway, It was a great song. It had a great message. And those were really my only two complaints, you know. And I'll probably listen to it again after I get done with the recording, just to make sure I didn't miss anything, you know. But there are a lot of visuals in there, obviously. The Dukes of Hazzard car, you know, the general, which is the car, and Boss Hog, and just the basic message of coming from nothing, having nothing, and having to overcome all these different things that are against them, generally, just to try to overcome those things. Good song. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. You guys have a fabulous Wednesday morning. And remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And what else? Yeah, you guys take care of each other, because no one else is going to. Ciao.